The learning from today has been about operational systems, about making our equipment work in a Spartan environment. We're in Greece, after all, but it's about getting our systems to work in suboptimal conditions.
So it's absolutely essential to do these sorts of field trials because it allows us to sort of simulate the pressure that's being put on people in the case of an actual event. So because there's lots of people watching and there's lots of things going on and there's lots of pressure to perform right now, you get at least a little bit of the sense of the pressure that's being put on people in case of a mass casualty event.
So we did this with 8 casualties. 4 we had contaminated with simulant and 4 we hadn't. And we were able to send them through the right decontamination lines in a short space of time and monitor them every single step of the way from a remote command post. It was extraordinary.
The biggest improvement from a CBRN incident is your ability to rapidly triage. At the moment, people are waiting and they are dying while they wait. And that is mainly because you have the worried well taking up time and those who are really truly contaminated can't get the help that they need.
We were able to show that someone had not been properly decontaminated before they cleared the decontamination line and we returned them back for proper decontamination. That would be life-saving in reality.